Thanks for joining. If you're watching this, you're either a recruiter in HR, a sourcer, or something very close to that. Welcome back to Recruiter Fuel. Andrew, thanks for joining me again.
Glad to be back.
So to all of you watching out there, I've got some really, really bad news that it's kind of like breaking news. Technology is going to replace you.
Uh-oh.
So this is what's happening right now. Everybody's talking about any type of technology replacing us as recruiters. Andrew, what's your take on that right now?
Well, it's happening in a lot of industries, so I can see when people hear that, they get a little nervous. I don't really believe it, because when you think of recruiting, a lot of people think get the resume, get the profile, contact the person and hire them. There's a lot more that goes into the stew or the recipe, if you will, that I just don't even understand how AI or any other job board or whatever it is can do that.
Now,
I don't get as worried.
Let's be fair, because all those tools are great. Mm-hmm. But I think, and all of you guys watching this, I know you've experienced this. I experienced this. I've been doing this 25 years. You don't even have to say how long you've been doing it, but I know it's been a long time as well. But I remember it was, oh my gosh, ATSs, it's going to put us out of business because you won't need anything else anymore. And then it was job boards, Monster, Career Builder, going to put us out of business. Then it was LinkedIn, and it's, oh my gosh, it's going to put us out of business. Yet we're still sitting here talking about technology, and we're still in business.
Yeah, and every day I hear ZipRecruiter is easier, the easiest way to do it on the radio, literally every morning and every time I drive home. And again, I think those tools are good. They're definitely helpful. They help people like myself and others, but I just think when you really get into the recruiting process, when you really look at sourcing candidates, whatever it may be, there's so much more to it that, you know, I'd just be surprised if somebody came out with something that could do it from end to end.
But let's face it. I mean, technology has made our job easier in some ways.
Definitely.
But I think harder. I mean, let's think about it. LinkedIn, and wonderful tool. We all use it. I don't know a recruiter who doesn't use it or doesn't use some type of Boolean search to scrape it, you know, whatever the case might be. It gives us access to a lot of people, positive, and a lot faster than back in the day of calls everywhere you had to call to find out who was who, right? But the negative of that is everybody's got access to the same people.
Yep.
So how does that play into this whole technology recruiting game from your perspective?
Well, I think sometimes, you know, when I started recruiting, we might get things that were more hot off the press, meaning new requisitions right when they needed them.
Yeah.
A lot of times we probably see our clients, because I ask, they started looking on LinkedIn or Career Builder, doing whatever it is, going through their ATS first. Then they realized, hey, wait a minute, we need professional recruiters to do this. So I think that, yes, it does make our lives easier because we use it. Maybe it, you know, people try that first before they come to us.
So you were telling me before we were actually started shooting this for everybody, of, you made the comment of, I wish technology would see this conversation, because you were just having a conversation with a client.
Yes.
Well, tell me about that, because you didn't elaborate on what the conversation was.
So we were talking about, you know, we went on a search for three different levels, probably a director, a manager, and an assistant in production. And, you know, we're talking about the candidates we found, what they're being paid, why they might be interested, why they might not be. And then the client and I were having a discussion about compensation. And, you know, I said we have a few different ways we can go. We can stay the course. We have to turn over a lot of rocks to find what we want. We can up the compensation, or we can maybe go a level down and look for someone that's promotable. Again, can technology do some of the sourcing, pull some of the resumes? Can you set that algorithm to look for this, this, and this? Yes, you can. But, you know, as far as getting into the data, presenting it to a client, giving a market outlook, you know, trying to give them a few different options to move forward, I think that's where recruiters and people in similar disciplines are still going to be very valuable and irreplaceable.
Technology is still not replacing some of those pieces.
Yes, because
but you said something interesting, Andrew. You said, you know, you can program the algorithm to go out and find these keywords. Who develops the keywords? Who tells the machine what to go after?
And that's the other thing is, I think I mentioned before we started filming, the intake call, that's the start of the recruiting process. When you talk to a new client or whoever it is, internal, external, you know, I have a 5-6 page questionnaire I go through with people. That is how a lot of the time you see what's in the job description versus what they really want. And, you know, if you just feed a job description into a system, an algorithm, whatever it is, yeah, you might get people that resemble that job description. But as we all know, the job description doesn't really always get you to where you need to be. So again, that's where professionals like us come in.
So some of the people watching are probably saying, ah, you guys have been doing it for too long. You're dinosaurs. technology is still going to overrun you in 3 years tops. I mean, what do you think? I mean, how do you look at that?
I think for maybe some of the more easier roles, like I need an accountant that does one or two things, bookkeeper, yeah, maybe. But a lot of the executive level roles, the hybrid roles, or the roles where you need a lot of competency screening, not just skill screening, and especially a lot of the sourcing to understand diversity, what people are making, those sort of things, I'm pretty confident I'm going to have a job in the next few years.
Yeah, and I even look at it from a sourcing perspective. I mean, I'm a technology geek. I love all things technology, smart home, every app and all that. And here in the organization, we leverage all that technology. But what's interesting is that the skill set to use the technology, now that seems to be changing recruiters a little bit, but it's actually becoming, you've got to know more to be a recruiter today than a few years ago even.
Yes, it definitely, not only do you have to know more just to use what you're given to do your job, but also you have to keep honing your craft, keep getting better at understanding your clients to show them that value, why they're calling you in the first place versus just going on those job boards or using those other gadgets or whatever it is.
You know, I look at it more like if you're going to get rid of recruiting, you might as well get rid of sales because you might as well automate everything that has to do with anything in sales. But we know you can't replace some of those relationships
no,
today.
You cannot.
You can augment it. You can support it through marketing and automation. Same thing in recruiting. There's no difference.
Yeah, and you mentioned relationships. You can get a candidate interested because you can say, hey, you know, you can get a message out to them. Hey, we'll pay you this. It doesn't matter if it's from a robot or a human. They're interested. But everybody in recruiting, HR, sourcing, you name it, they know there's a lot that goes into when that candidate gets the offer, you know, getting them interested in a company, going, you know, figuring out from their end what is important, what's not important, what they actually see in a job versus, you know, what it says in the job description. There's so much more to that relationship, not just with the client relationships that, again, I just don't see how, you know, a machine will be better than a human.
Yeah, I don't see a machine having a conversation with you to figure out how to turn you from a not interested candidate to an interested candidate based on your drivers and emotions and so on. I just don't see it happening.
That would be a tough one. If those people can invent something like that, they're probably going to be very, very rich.
Well, you got the Google thing where they actually made a reservation with a human voice using one of the new Google apps, and everybody freaked out about it. But to literally have a two-way conversation to pick up on emotions and cues and so on that we do, recruiters in general do so well, to give that to a recruiter and to program every potential viable option into that algorithm that you have to respond, I just don't see it happening anytime soon.
Yeah, it's thinking on your feet. I think that's what a lot of my job is when I'm calling people, because I hit the phone hard. I'm more old school. Do I use the social media and stuff? Yes. Do I use the job boards? Yes. But I still pick up the phone, and really my job's thinking on my feet. No matter what plan I go in with, it's, you know, you really got to react to the person you're getting, their attitude, how they answer the phone, what they're looking for. And again, I just think that as of now, I feel pretty good in my spot as a recruiter because I just don't think you're going to be able to take the human interaction out of that.
Yeah, I agree with you. Andrew, thank you for taking the time.
Thank you.
Look, we are huge advocates of technology. I think technology is an integral piece of recruiting in just about every industry at all. But I challenge any of you that are saying it's going to replace what we do as recruiters. I think it will change and continue to change what we do as recruiters, but it's absolutely not going to put us out of work. I don't believe, at least not my lifetime, and Andrew, I don't believe in your lifetime.
Definitely.
Guys, thanks for being with us. Make sure you check back in a week. We'll have another episode coming your way.